Welcome back, everyone. So yesterday, the left-wing Democrat Party State media was up in arms over the Supreme Court's ruling that New York cannot discriminate against houses of worship in its anti-pandemic restrictions. So, of course, over at DNCNN, they brought on one of their frequent Republican bashers to claim that the ruling was, quote, anti-science and devalues human life. We'll get right into that, but first, this very quick message from our sponsors at Noble Gold. If you're anything like me, you're wondering, what's going on with these markets? Will they grow or come crashing down? That's why Noble Gold is inviting you to get safe with gold this time. They're gifting a solid 24-karat American Gold Eagle coin and a spectacular display case with every qualifying IRA or 401k, started before the end of November. So go to www.noblegoldinvestments.com and get this special coin offer. Or you can call 877-646-5347.
I want to pivot, sir, to the Supreme Court's ruling overnight. They blocked New York's coronavirus restrictions, limiting attendance at churches, synagogues, and other houses of worship. I know a lot of folks that I've discussed this with, they're asking about religious freedom and how certain officials are appearing to prioritize commerce over worship. Correct me if I'm wrong, there are specific reasons why going in a church, a synagogue, or a mosque can be problematic compared to going to, say, a liquor store.
It's absolutely crazy. This is not about religious freedom. This is not about civil liberties. This is about all hands on deck to save lives over the next few months till we get everybody vaccinated. You know, I can say with firmness and clarity that human life is not cheap. And that Supreme Court ruling did just that. It devalues human lives.
Okay, so first off, they never mentioned that New York churches are limited to 10 people, unlike in most states where it's limited to 25. That seems deceptive to me right off the bat. But then the doctor goes on to say that going to church is problematic compared to going to, say, a liquor store. His implication obviously being that when you go into a liquor store, you're in there quickly and with a small amount of people. Well, that really depends on how busy it is, doesn't it? You could potentially be standing around in a big line for a while. It's happened to me before. When it does come to churches, it appears to me that they've been taking all the standard precautions. This New York Times article shows a church that appears to be social distancing and everyone appears to be wearing masks. My other question would be, how is it any different than going to a grocery store or a department store? It seems like this doctor used the liquor store example because he knows that people are going to grocery stores where they're going to be with a lot of people for a long period of time. According to these New York State guidelines for retail grocery stores, they only limit the people to 50% of the store's capacity. So there's definitely going to be more than 10 people in these grocery stores. That being said, I'm not a scientist, I'm not an epidemiologist, and I'm not even particularly smart. However, one can plainly see the partisan double standards being applied to these restrictions and see that this science that they keep talking about isn't as certain as they keep leading on. For example, over at CNN in September, they declared that BLM protests are safe from COVID outbreaks. But somehow, Trump rallies aren't.
I think it's important for us to, as public health experts, to lead with the science. And the science tells us that this is a virus that does not discriminate. It doesn't care why it is that people are gathering. So outdoors, much safer than indoors. Wearing masks, obviously much safer than not wearing masks. And I also, in this case, would distinguish between the behavior of the participants while at protests versus rallies of the risks and are doing everything they can to reduce that risk. Versus at many of these rallies, we're seeing people going in defiance, and it's their behavior during those events.
Dr. Lena Wen, thanks for breaking through the fog of confusion and disinformation to lead us back to the facts.
It's like I always say, the only legitimate protest is one pushing a left-wing or Democrat Party agenda. I mean, just look at how differently these lockdown protests were covered in Michigan. They were outdoors and relatively small. Some people were wearing masks and others weren't. But when you look at the reporting, it's all very negative, accusing them of being racists or otherwise demonizing the group as armed and dangerous. Just look at this hit piece on the anti-lockdown protests, and you'll even see in the picture that while some people aren't wearing masks, many of them are. While stories about BLM are always positive and running cover for the group, But if you just look at this picture that they provided, you're going to see that while many people are wearing masks, but you also see that many people aren't wearing masks. If you just look through the picture, you're going to see many that aren't. And there's definitely no social distancing going on here. Yet, if you look, you're going to find story after story claiming that none of these mass protests were to blame for any COVID-19 spikes. But again, looking at this picture that NBC provided, you're going to see that while some people are wearing masks, many aren't.
Thanks for breaking through the fog of confusion and disinformation to lead us back to the facts.
Medical professionals even united to declare that any risk of spreading COVID pale in comparison to the importance of protesting racial injustice, which, by the way, has never been proven in any of the cases that have been used as excuses to burn, loot, and pillage for the last 6 months. Just because a black person, or any person for that matter, is shot by police doesn't automatically mean that racism or injustice are to blame. Sure, it's a possibility, but these leftist media outlets just assume for the purposes of pushing a political agenda. My point here is that all of these restrictions and the media shaming all appear to be very partisan and agenda-driven. If there is a real danger here, then it's the media and the Democrat politicians played a big part in why people are distrustful of these restrictions. Later in the show, they brought on another Democrat posing as an analyst who declared that the Supreme Court is now far right.
It clearly is now a court controlled by a 5-justice majority without Chief Justice John Roberts, which is a very new development for this court. 5 justices on the far right saying no, the overriding free exercise concerns are what's important here, and we're not going to defer to local officials, and it's time to stop what the majority believes is a nationwide trend against religious services.
I only wanted to throw this in there to demonstrate how partisanship is playing a much larger role in all of this than they'll ever admit. I mean, on what basis can she claim that this SCOTUS ruling proves that the Supreme Court is now far right? What about the Constitution and ending discrimination against these churches is far right? Perhaps from her vantage point as a far leftist, everything looks like it's far right. Like all the other labels used by these Orwellian creatures, lobbing it is supposed to instantly discredit their target. I've pointed out before that the media regularly uses terms like right wing or far right interchangeably as a weapon, but rarely, if ever, say things like left wing or far left. As we head into a possible Biden administration, his mass media complex is already ramping up propaganda efforts on his behalf. As long as this channel exists, I will continue to call them out. You can support me in that mission by using one of the links in the description or pinned comment. Turn off your TV and let me watch this crap for you. That's all for this one. If you enjoyed it, you know what to do. Thanks for watching. I'll see you all next time.